Hello everyone and welcome back to Crack Keys, and in today's video we are going to look upon our first geography chapter of class 9th, India, size and location. So let's get started. So as you can see on the screen, the chapter is there. So let's first know some facts about India. So our first fact is India is one of the ancient civilizations in the world. Which means that it is also considered one of the ancient civilizations, means the civilizations which were there in the really past time. And then our second fact is it has achieved multi-phased socio-economic progress during the last 5 decades or last 50 years. And now it has moved forward, displaying remarkable progress in the field of agriculture, industry, technology and overall economic development. India has also contributed significantly to the making of world history. So that's all about India. So now let's talk about the geographical features of India. So before that geographical features, I just want to introduce you with some of our meridians, latitudes and longitudes. So let's talk about them. So as you can see on the screen, we are having 5 main types of latitudes: Arctic Circle, Tropic of Cancer, Equator, Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. And the one and the area which is above equator is known as Northern Hemisphere, and the area which is coming to Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer is known as parallels of latitudes, and the area below equator is known as Southern Hemisphere, and the area between Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle are known as meridians of longitude. So now at 90 degree we got the North Pole, and at the South Pole we get it the 90 degree South. So now let's come on to our chapter. So our chapter is location. So we were talking about location. So India is a vast country lying entirely in the Northern Hemisphere. So Northern Hemisphere, as we talk about the portion above Northern Hemisphere, so above equator. Okay, so it's lying completely in the Northern Hemisphere, as you can see in this picture also. This is our equator and this is our India. Then the main land extends between latitudes 8 degree 4 north and 37 degree 6 north. Okay, so here they want to say that the main length of the India is this 8 degree 4 south and 37 degree 6 north. Actually we consider it both as north, because the India is entirely falling into the Northern Hemisphere, so we will just call it north, not the south. So it's starting from 37 degrees 6 north from Jammu and Kashmir and ending here near this with 8 degree 4 north. Okay, so this was the longitude, and the latitude over here is that 96 degree 25 east and 68 degree 7 east. So this was about the latitude and longitudinal coordinates of India. So and there is one more main meridian, also known as prime meridian, which divides earth into two more parts known as eastern and western part. And then after dividing it into both ones, we get that here in the North America side we got northwest, and in the Asia side we get northeast, and in this Southern Australia side we get southeast, and in this South America side we get this southwest. So these are the main directions of us. So India also lies entirely into the northeastern hemisphere. So that's why we were talking about east only over there. So the Tropic of Cancer, which we discussed here, which is dividing which is at 23 degree 26 north. So this divides India into two equal parts. So obviously it's not perfectly two, but it's approx two equal parts which are equal to them. So to the southeast and southwest of the mainland lie the Andaman and Nicobar. So to south as east and southwest of the mainland lie the Andaman and Nicobar, as you can see here. In the southland we are having Andaman and Nicobar. So then Andaman and Nicobar Island at the southeast, and the Lakshadweep Islands in the southwest here. This one is the southeast one, Andaman and Nicobar, and southeast, southwest, Lakshadweep. Southeast and southwest. Southwest, Lakshadweep, and southeast, Andaman and Nicobar is there. So now, and in Bay of Bengal, Arabian Sea, also there are some group of islands which are under India. So now let's talk about size of India. So the landmass of India has an area of 3.28 million square kilometer. India's total area accounts for about 2.4% of the total geographical area. So it means here that the first they are telling us the total amount, total area of India, total landmass area of India, which is 3.28 million square kilometer, and it almost covers the 2.4% of the total geographical area. Means this all area, from this all land, India is covering 2.4% of the all land which is available. So from figure 1.2, it is clear that India is the seventh largest country. So let me show you the figure 1.2. So our figure 1.2 is just nothing. It's the one which is comparing which country is having the largest area in square kilometers. So first one is Russia, then Canada, USA, China, Brazil, Australia, and India. So Russia is also known as USSR, United States of Soviet Russia. And as Canada is the second most biggest country, and USA is coming on the third one, and then China, Brazil, Australia, and India. So India is the seventh largest country of this world. It is having six more countries which are larger than that. So India almost have a land boundary about 15,200 kilometers, and the total length of the coastline of the mainland, including Andaman and Nicobar, is 7,516.6 kilometer. So this land boundary is 15,200 kilometer, means the area of this much, only this much, the boundary which are covering any land. These boundaries which are having blue lines, those are coastlines. And here they are telling the total perimeter of the coastline, so including Andaman and Nicobar Islands and Lakshadweep Islands also. They are considered their coastline also as the same coast, and adding those into the India's total coastline. So India is bounded by the Yangfold Mountain in the northwest and north and northeast. So basically India is having so here the northwest, and here the north and northeast. So all over here we are having Himalayas, which are known as Yangfold Mountains. Okay, so we are totally covered from that side. South of about 22 degree north latitude, it begins to taper and extends over the Indian Ocean. So about 22 degree north, when we go, it starts steeping up, means it goes thin, and till the Indian Ocean, dividing till the Indian Ocean it goes and divides two seas, Arabian Sea on the west and Bay of Bengal on its east. Now let's look at the figure 1.3 and note that the latitude and longitude extent of the mainland is about 30 degrees. Despite this fact, the east-west extent appears to be smaller than the northeast-south extent. So basically they want to say that the difference here, not the correct one but approx. So and so this one and this one, if we compare this one, it's larger than this one, because India is a country which is longer than which is longer in the longitudinal area, whereas it's a little small in the latitudinal area. That's why we are calling it like that. So from Gujarat through Arunachal Pradesh, there is a big time lag of 2 hours. Hence, time along the standard meridian of India passing through Mirzapur in Uttar Pradesh is taken as a standard meridian time. So the here Arunachal Pradesh and Gujarat, these are the two states of India which are in the south and east extent, east and from the northeast and this east extent. So they are having a time lag of 2 hours. Means if there is 6 o'clock in Gujarat, then there it would be 4 on. So it was making their work a little confusing, as their offices were starting at 10 and they were awake at 4, because the sun rises there at 4. But so they asked for a new timeline for them, but it was refused, because if they do that, then the timings of flights, airplane, flights, trains and other things will go like in a confusing manner, and there would be so much lagging in the transportation things. So they put a standard meridian which is passing through Uttar Pradesh, which is right over here, a place called Mirzapur, and this standard meridian decides the time here also and here also. So that's a thing which was taken. So the latitudinal extent influences the duration of day and night as one moves from south to north. So if we will go to towards here, the time will be different and there would be different. So it depends, because the sun rises from the east, so the east or easter ones would get the sun early than the western ones. So that's why it was like that. So India and the world. The Indian landmass has a central location between the East and the West Asia. India is southward extension of the Asian continent. The trans-Indian ocean routes which connect the countries of Europe in the West and the countries of East Asia. So as you can see the shape of this India, it is a little strategical, because as you can see it is connecting two areas, the Eastern Asia and the Western Asia, like from here. So, and it is having a peninsula shape, so it can easily connect with the Eastern ones and Western ones for the trade. And so now the southward, so this we are on already read. So it connects the countries of Europe in the west and the countries of East Asia, provide a strategical central location to India. Note that Deccan Peninsula protrudes into the Indian Ocean. So basically this all area is Deccan plateau, this much after this line. So because it's a peninsula, basically is the one which is covered with water from three sides. So we named it as peninsula, thus helping India to establish close contact with West Asia, Africa and Europe from the western coast, and with Southeast and East Asia from the eastern coast. No other country has a long coastline on the Indian Ocean, as India has indeed. It is the eminent position in the Indian Ocean which justifies the name of an ocean arm. So because India is having the largest coastline in the Indian Ocean, so that's why it was named after India, Indian Ocean. So this is obvious. If it is having the largest coastline, then only the ocean would be under its name. So India's contacts with the world have continued through ages, but her relationship through the land routes are much older than her maritime contacts. Means India is having contact with the world and have continued through ages, means it's going through many ages, but her relationship through the land routes are much older, means they're more older than these relationships. The various passes across the mountains in the north have provided passage to the ancient travelers. So as in the movies we see that we are having tunnels to the mountains. So in the ancient time also they were having tunnels so that they can pass through the Himalayan mountains and come here and there. So that helped many travelers in the ancient time. These routes have contributed in the exchange of ideas and commodities. So obviously, if the people are changing their position, they are moving from one country to another, the ideas would be exchanged and commodities would also be exchanged. The ideas of Upanishads and the Ramayana, the stories of Panchatantra, the Indian numerals and the decimal system thus could reach many parts of the world. So when Aryabhatta discovered zero, if this thing was not there, the close contact of India through routes with the different country was not there, then many countries would not be able to think that there is something called zero invented by India. So that's the important thing here, and same they are saying for Upanishad, Ramayana and Panchatantra also. So the spices, muslin and other merchandise, so these are some famous things which Britishers also came for in India, the spices, muslin and other merchandise. So on the other hand, the influence of Greek sculpture and the architectural styles of dome and minarets from West Asia can be seen in different parts of the country. So it's true that in the Greek culture they were having the dome-like structures, and in India now we can find many monuments like that which are having those dome-like structures. So that's all about this India and the world. Now we will talk about this India and neighbors. So India occupies an important strategic position, as we learned before, in South Asia. India has 28 states and 9 union territories. So now it's a little different, I think. Now we are having 29 states and 8 union territories. So India shares its land boundaries with Pakistan, Afghanistan in the northwest, China, Nepal and Bhutan in the north, and Myanmar and Bangladesh in the east. Our southern neighbors across the sea consist of the two island countries, namely, Sri Lanka and Maldives. Sri Lanka is separated from India by the Bock Strait, also known as Rampul, which was made during, I think, Ramayana. So they named it Bock Strait and the Gulf of Mannar, while Maldives Islands are situated to the south of the Lakshadweep Islands. So they only want to tell us about the countries in which India is sharing the boundaries. So I think we should learn these. So actually we all know which are the countries who are sharing border with India: Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan and Myanmar, Bangladesh. And there are two island countries also who are sharing boundaries: Sri Lanka, Maldives. Okay, so India has a strong geographical and historical links with her neighbors. Look at the physical map of Asia in your atlas and note how India stands apart from the rest of Asia. So as you can see in this map, India is a little bit different from other things. It is having a thing like they are having a strategical shape, as we discussed above, and it can connect with many states. Like through here it can connect to Africa, here Europe and other things. So this was all about this all thing. So now let's discuss these question answers. So exercises. So our question number one is: choose the right answer from the four alternatives given below. So our first one is: the Tropic of Cancer does not pass through. So I think Tropic of Cancer passed through Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh also, and Tripura also, but it doesn't pass from Odisha. So for answer should be Odisha. The easternmost longitude of India is 97 degree 25 east, 68 degree 7 east, yes, or 77 degrees 6 east or 82 degrees 32 east. So I think it would be the answer. A part 97 degrees 25 east. As you can see here, it was there. Yes. At the other side, we are 68 degrees 7. Okay. So now comes the third one. Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, West Bengal, and Sikkim have common frontiers with. So they are having common frontiers with Nepal, as all of them are at the northeast corner. Uttarakhand is somewhere here. As you see, Uttarakhand and Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Sikkim, and West Bengal. So this all is so here is the West Bengal, and it touches the Nepal boundary very sharply. So if you intend to visit Kawarati during a summer vacation, which one is the following union territories of India you will be going to? So I guess we would be going to Lakshadweep, because it's the capital of Lakshadweep, Kawarati. My friend hails from a country which does not share land boundary with India. Identify the country. I think it should be Tajikistan, because it's after this Afghanistan here, Tajikistan. The boundary is not there. So now answer the questions briefly. So name the group of islands lying in the Arabian Sea. So the group of islands lying in the Arabian Sea, let's see from the map. So I guess Arabian Sea is here, so only this, what you call Lakshadweep is there. Lakshadweep and the group of islands lying in the Arabian Sea. So Lakshadweep and Maldives are there, which will be written up here. So the second part says, name the countries which are larger than India. So we are having 6 countries larger than India: USSR, United States of Soviet Russia, Canada, USA, United States of America, China, Brazil, Australia. So these are the 6 countries which are larger than India. So after that, which island group of India lies to its southeast? So at southeast, I think this area would be the southeast. So Andaman and Nicobar lies to the southeast. Okay. Which island countries are our southern neighbors? So Sri Lanka and Maldives are our southern neighbors. Okay. So I guess the question answers ends here. So we are having sunrises 2 hours later earlier in the Arunachal Pradesh as compared to Gujarat in the west, but the watches show the same time. How does this happen? This happened because of this standard meridian, and the watches doesn't change this time because as there was 2 hours difference, so they created a standard meridian, and the standard meridian declared the same time in the both the states. So the central location of India at the head of the Indian Ocean is considered of great significance, because it is having a strategical location from east. It can trade with these states. It was written over here where it goes. I guess it was right over here. In the Indian landmass has a central location between East and West Asia. India is a southward extension of the Asian continent. The trans-Indian Ocean routes, which connect the countries of Europe in the West, it connects to Europe in West, and it connects to East Asia, provide a strategic central location to India. So this all we can write over here. And I think this much in answer would be enough. So our question answer ends here. Now the chapter, that's all in this chapter. Now the chapter ends here. Now we will meet in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye bye. See you soon.